everyone. Heather Earls here. Thanks for coming on today's episode. This week, like every week, I'll be talking about natural living and healthy tips that will get you to rethink how you live and what products or habits you can easily change to better your life. So let's get started. Hey, you guys, and welcome to this week's episode. We're going to be talking about the top travel tips for summer. Now, keep listening as there's a lot of healthy tips in here, whether it's food and or keeping a positive attitude, okay? So summer is a time for fun, but also a time for traveling since school is out. Parents at last can relax and take a break from the norm, and the kids can see their cousins, friends, or parts of the world that are new. Yes, to travel is a grand adventure, but it can also be a little stressful to plan or keep people occupied in the car. I've just returned from a 26-hour car ride and am well aware of the do's and don'ts when traveling. So let's get right into them. Number one, travel light. Whether you are traveling as a couple or with children, the vehicle can become very small the farther you need to go. To avoid feeling claustrophobic or stressed, keep your car clean, travel light, and use your trunk or storage area when you do not need something. Number two, stop and get some fresh air. By stopping, you give your legs and body a chance to get the circulation moving. You also help prevent accidents by clearing your head. We all want to get to our destination, but it's not healthy to sit for an extended length of time. So you want to get out, stretch, and exchange stale air for fresh, reviving your brain and helping to prevent headaches. Like I said, a lot of these tips have to do with just well-being. So number three is pack healthy snacks. People like to snack, that is nothing new, but when you are stuck in a vehicle, plan ahead and take something that will not leave you feeling guilty. If it's healthy, snack away, enjoying the freshness of veggies, fruits, and nuts. Try to avoid stopping at gas stations and just buying whatever, chips, because you're hungry. So planning ahead is a big one. Number four, bring activities for the children. There's nothing a parent dislikes more than to hear the dreaded words, "Are we there yet?" Children, depending on their age, do not understand time as well as we would like. An hour to them seems like an eternity, which is why an activity is helpful. Now, I don't encourage electronics. I'm kind of old school that way, but I do like to promote games like, "What type of shape do you see in the clouds?" The movie game where someone has to sing a chorus and another person has to guess what movie it's from. For smaller kids, you could do coloring, or older kids, you could do reading books. Or an old-time classic is Roadkill Bingo. All right, number five, keep it positive. Okay, this is for when you're traveling or when you're just staying at home. Someone is going to get tired, but that doesn't mean it's okay to start snapping at each other. Words are powerful and can leave a deep wound. Stopping or turning on music or audios are all good ideas that will prevent you from having to apologize. And or if you have one of those vehicles where the top opens up, again, just let in some fresh air if you don't want to stop again. Roll down a window. Okay, number six, don't be one of those people that demands silence or curses when someone has to go to the bathroom. People like to talk and pee, and if you have a problem with that, you should plan on taking a trip very close to home or go by yourself. Okay, seven, if you see something interesting along the road, then pull over. Traveling can be so exciting when you deviate from the plan. Now, I'm not talking about stopping every mile, but hard charging it until you reach your hotel doesn't allow you to enjoy the beauty you might see along the way. Number eight, always have a plan B. You never know when a place you usually stop out will be sold out because of a softball tournament or whatever. Have a couple of towns in mind and check on hotels before you start so that you won't end up sleeping in your car if that's not something you want to do. All right, number nine, keep your gas tank half full. I can't tell you how many times I've been at a dead stop with road construction looking at my gas gauge going, "Ooh, I hope I make it." Number 10, carry a first aid bag or container. When you're on the road, unexpected things will happen and you need to prepare for them. not just for your safety, but in case you need to help someone else. I'm a big person for carrying stuff or being prepared so that you are willing and able to help somebody else, not always just yourself. Okay, so number 11, check your tires, fluids, and before you ever begin, check your spare tire. A well-oiled machine is more likely to get you to your destination. And number 12, if you carry a concealed weapon, know the laws in the states where you will be traveling. Traveling is half planning, the other half is enjoying. So use these top travel tips so you and your passengers have a great time and don't stress. All right, happy trails, you guys. Talk to you next week. Thanks for listening to today's episode of Urban Wisdom and Natural Living. Tune in next week, where I'll broadcast live every Monday morning at 8 a.m. If you miss it live, hold those tears and head on over to my blog, which is heatherearles.com. That's Heather, EARLES.com. There you can have 24/7 access or right here on iTunes. If you want to follow me on social media, you'll find me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and Pinterest. Have a healthy week.